What's up, P Nation? This is a video we are most excited to show you. We came down to Antarctica and we finally saw some penguins. Cue the penguin montage. That was amazing. That was filmed in like 3 different days and it was just unbelievable.
So we talked a little bit more about the penguins while we were actually on our camping trip while it was still fresh on the mind. So here it is. This has been such an exciting week for us. Not only are we getting to camp in Antarctica, but earlier this week we actually got an up close and personal interaction or encounter with
some penguins. It was amazing.
They we filmed are it all. So little.
Yeah, we should have vlogged like talking to you guys, but it was just really windy, so we probably couldn't have done that. So we're gonna tell you about it now and show you the amazing shots of the penguins we saw. Started about 2 weeks ago when Leah went out to this place called
Hut Point,
and basically it's just where the ice starts breaking off and it's where a lot of activity from the currents are, as well as we just had our icebreaker come in to town, and so it just created this huge hole in the ice where all this marine activity could come up through the ice and basically lay around, play around,
and that's
waddle.
What they've been doing for the past 2 weeks. We've seen penguins, we've seen
whales.
We've seen seals. We've seen jellyfish.
Oh yeah.
And skuas.
Big jellyfish.
It's been very exciting. Like it's been the talk of the town. The entire town has been out to Hut Point just trying to see whales and penguins. And there is this whole Antarctic treaty where you're not allowed to approach an animal, or you can get in trouble. But if you are staying still and they approach you,
there's like a tree.
No big deal. Because like the whole point is that so that you're not
interfering.
Yeah, so if like they're changing what they're doing because of your presence, that's bad. But if you are just standing there and they approach you,
so she went out twice to go look for them. I went out once to go look for the penguins. Both times we saw them swimming around. I think you saw one stealing a rock from another penguin.
Yeah, so I was watching intently as these penguins were trying to get up this mountain or like hillside, and they got to this exposure of rock from the sea ice, and I guess Adelie penguins do this thing where they pick up rocks when they're trying to mate.
So cute.
It is cute. So they're picking up rocks and they were choosing rocks for like their mating ritual, and one penguin stole a rock from another penguin and it was like
game on.
Yeah, it was terrible. I mean, it was absolutely adorable, but he was like chasing him around and like yelling, and the whole like squad started yelling and they were just like squawking at each other. It was really, really
cute. You came
cute.
Back and you told us where you're so excited. Which then inspired us to get a trip with our friends to go out on our day off, because we only get one day off a week, to go and see these penguins in action. And that's when it happened. We just walked up and it was the first thing that we saw. Oh, there's three penguins on the ice. And they started walking towards us, and so we started walking towards them, and then we stopped, and they veered off, and then all of a sudden,
they came back. Right up to us.
And they walked up the hill. I don't know how. We just figured out penguins have knees.
So they're just really good jumpers.
I don't know how they made it up the hill. Made it up the hill, and so I was on one knee filming one, and then I was like, oh, I am way too close to this penguin because he kept coming at me. And so I stood up, stood by Leah, and then he kept coming towards me. Towards me, and then he got within 4 feet of you
or less. He walked right by us. Like, it was really, really crazy. We were kind of just like frozen in shock. Like, I can't believe this is actually happening right now.
A wild penguin has chosen Leah
yes
as a best friend. It was amazing. was so cool. And then for the rest of the day, we just proceeded to watch these penguins swim around in groups. Sometimes they were chasing minke whales. Sometimes they were chasing seals. There was one time they all got up on the ice, and then a helicopter came by. And they all dove in at the same time. It's just like so many adorable things are happening here. And we just feel so lucky that we could have come to Antarctica and have these amazing experiences. It truly is an amazing continent. Okay, and that was the camping trip we went hiking on, and we've gotten a lot of questions about how hiking goes in Antarctica. Are you hiking on ice? Do you have to have ice picks at all times? Are there crevasses? Are you on glaciers? And basically,
all of those things. You can do anything really here while the sea ice is still thick. So you can see behind us, it's all broken up. During different times of the year, you can actually go on hikes out on the sea ice because at some points it's like 6 feet deep or 6 feet thick. And so you do need to check in with base camp, and you need to bring a radio with you just in case you get into trouble. And there are crevasses, so you need to be careful. But if you just stay on the path, you are golden, you are good to go, and you should be rather safe.
And we actually have a video that we took about 2 months ago when the ice was still frozen solid and there was no water behind us. And now you're gonna see that now.
It's a very exciting day because today is quite warm for Antarctica standards. It's about 20 degrees and we're about to go on a hike. So we're about to do the Armitage Loop, and it should take about 2.5 hours, and you actually go out on the Ross Sea Ice Shelf. So it's really cool, and we're gonna do that now. Let's go. Right behind me is one of the most rare sights you'll see here, a plane landing.
So this is where we live. The blue building is where we go in every day. Our building that we stay in is right there. And then this gigantic mountain behind everything is an active volcano called Erebus. How much cooler can you get? And this is one of the shelters that the scientists use. It's on skis, as you can see, and they just hook it up to one of the machines and they can take it out for research. Okay, and now we are on the main road, and these little flags are made of bamboo, which is really funny because literally nothing grows here. We're in a desert, even though we're surrounded by snow. I don't know if you can see, but way over there is what we call the Penguin Ranch. And that's where they're doing penguin research on penguins. I want to go there so bad. Apparently the way they tackle the penguin is they have to get down on their knees and just hug them from behind. And the penguin will be like, okay, I'll play with you. And then they can do their research on him for one to two hours, just depends. I think that is so cool. And then it's just so relaxing today because the wind's not blowing. This is super rare. And so me and Leah just laid down in the snow for like 20 minutes. And that's what I do every time I have a yoga session here. I just imagine I'm on this ice. And there's seals and penguins and sea spiders and everything's just under me living, and I'm just here on the frozen tundra. That day was amazing. It was so nice to just lay on the ice and be in Antarctica with
so
seals
peaceful.
Swimming under us. Yeah, it was amazing.
But of course there are hikes on the actual island we live on, which is Ross Island. You can go out to Hut Point Loop where we've seen most of our penguins. You can go up Ob Hill, that's kind of behind us, and that's a doozy of a hike. You can do the Ob Hill Loop, which just goes around it, which gives you kind of like a full view of the Ross Island or Ross Bay, which is really awesome. Mm-hmm. And you get to see Scott Base from there. Mm-hmm. You can go on the Castle Rock excursion, and with that one you do have to bring a buddy because it can get a little tricky. So there's a huge formation, rock formation, out like up above us pretty much, because we're kind of on a slope that goes down to the water. Mm-hmm. So above McMurdo Station, there's a huge rock that you can actually climb up. And I've been too scared to do it. But a lot of people
That's
do it.
That's the last challenge. Oh my gosh. And speaking of challenges, this hill behind us is Ob Hill, like Leah was saying. And if you hike it 39 times, there's a challenge here that's the equivalent of hiking Everest.
Yes.
That's crazy. So we've had a couple friends that have finished that feat, but we've been busy editing, of course.
Yeah. Also, I think we're a little bit lazier than our friends. Which, at least for me, is very active.
Oh my gosh.
I've done it once and I thought that was good enough.
But hiking in Antarctica is fun, especially when it's summertime.
Yes, it feels really nice. You just have to be careful about not getting caught up in a lot of wind and just choosing the right day. If it's sunshine, you might have a lot of wind because that means the clouds are like being blown off. If you choose kind of like a more overcast day, it can actually be calmer. So you'd think it would be the exact opposite, that on a sunny day like this, that it would be super calm, which today it is. But
so calm.
It's not always that way. Weather in Antarctica is very tricky and you have to be very careful. So if you just use your head and you're a little bit more careful than you normally would be on a regular hike on a regular continent, you'll be fine.
All right, thank you so much for watching our video. Antarctica is truly an amazing place to be.
I can't believe we're here. Every day is an adventure and this place is awesome.
Oh my God, it feels so hard. Oh, you can make it. He hit his head twice. Oh, it's the worst luck.